Terry here from My Quick Bookkeeping. I've seen many clients get themselves into a complete mess with the undeposited funds account. What we're going to do today is walk through the steps to receive checks from customers, group them together and deposit them later, and also understand how undeposited funds works when you're using payment processing through QuickBooks. Be sure to watch to the end of the video because then we'll have a look in the balance sheet and you'll be able to see if you've processed everything correctly. And today we're in the US sample company. So let's take a look at the balance sheet. Here you can see undeposited funds showing up under other current assets. Note that if you're in Canada, this account normally shows up a little closer to the top near the bank accounts. Now it's really important that you monitor this account and be sure it clears to zero regularly. So we have a balance of $2,062.52, which is made up of receipts from Cool Cars here of $1,675.52 and $387 from Freeman's Sporting Goods. These amounts have been received but not yet deposited. Let's have a look at how they got into the account. Let's receive a payment from Bill's Wilt's Windsurf Shop. Bill's going to pay his total amount, $85, and he's going to pay it by check. You'll see here the account that we selected is undeposited funds. This is because we're not going to put it in the bank right now. We're going to wait until we have a few checks and then go to the bank. Let's do that now. We'll grab our bank deposit book and see what checks we have. Select bank deposit. Look, here are two we identified earlier, along with Bill's check. Add them all together, and we can record the deposit. If you have a look at our balance sheet now, you can see that undeposited funds is zero. Nothing waiting to be deposited. Now, if you're accepting payments via credit card through QuickBooks payment processing, the procedure is very similar but automated. The payment will appear in undeposited funds as soon as the payment is processed. The customer pays, and QuickBooks updates the information so that your accounts receivable is reduced and the amount is pending the deposit. I'll pop into here, from the dashboard. When the funds are paid to you by QuickBooks, they will appear in your bank feed. Just like this amount here from, where is it, Travis Walden. Where did it go? Here we go. You can now match the deposit and it will be removed from undeposited funds and recorded in your bank. It's important that you don't record the payment when the customer pays using this method, as then the payment from QuickBooks will not post correctly. The allocation of payments to invoices will be messed up and you could end up with amounts in undeposited funds that are difficult to clear. So remember, if the payment's automated through QuickBooks, touch nothing until you can match the transactions through this bank feed here. Let me know if you have any questions and if this video was useful. Click like below, subscribe to my channel for lots more QuickBooks tips and how-tos. As I mentioned earlier, I've created a small business month-end checklist. If you click the link below, you can sign up for my newsletter, receive the checklist, and then you'll be able to see at a glance every month that everything is all up to date and your records are accurate to help you run your business better. If there is another topic that you'd like some help on, please do not make a note below because I would love to make my next video for you. Thanks. Cheers.